Mr. Fry, I trust that you had a productive meeting with Mr. Owen.
Oh, yes. We had a most wonderful chat. I found out the man behind Staric's soothing syrup is John Elliotson.
Dr. Elliotson, I haven't heard that name in a long while. He was a brilliant heart specialist until he became obsessed with phrenology and mesmerism. It ruined his career. Well, how shall we proceed?
Oh, with all respect, Mr. Darwin, I believe I should proceed alone. After all, we wouldn't want to attract any unwanted attention.
Sounds very wise. Good luck, my boy. Oh, and Mr. Fry, should you find yourself with any free time, please do call on me.
Don't be afraid to spill a little blood. Yes, Gal.
Where would I find the doctor?
He's not supposed to be here! Here!
As you've just witnessed, the application of too much pressure can sometimes result in unexpected outcomes. Unfortunately, it appears I've ruined the organ. Send up a cadaver.
At once, Dr. Litson.
I don't care about your ethics, and I care even less about your damn patience. Now hand over your keys.
What are you doing?
Haven't you heard? You're fired. Now bugger off.
To do it.
Yeah.
how to do it.
Supposed to be here!
Never find him now.
Oh!
business in London has not gone unnoticed.
Especially.
I don't want to die.
Run.
At last it ends. Yet I can only think of beginnings. A better tomorrow. Forged with the blood of visionaries.
All I see is the blood of a lunatic.
Do you truly believe murdering an old man will stop humanity's great architect? Crawford's Steric has a glorious design for mankind.
Designs are meant to be broken.
You're a child. A child who believes it can solve all the world's woes with a flick of a blade. Have you ever pondered the consequences of your actions, Jacob Fry? Or did your father teach you nothing?
All right.
You set me up. Still in the running, I hope.
Elliot's an expired, and soothing syrup production has ceased. Outrageous!
Fry intends to endanger all of London at the hands of the mob.
Or perhaps he doesn't intend much of anything at all.
Thank you.
He's simply content to dice with our lives.
The asylum is shut up. Medical care throughout the city is in disarray. He does not, cannot understand the consequences of his actions. The man is clearly an anarchist!
Gentlemen. This tea was brought to me from India, by a ship, then up from the harbor to a factory, where it was packaged and ferried by carriage to my door, unpacked in the larder and brought upstairs to me. All by men and women who work for me, who are indebted to me, Crawford Steric, for their jobs, the time, the very lives they lead. They will work in my factories, and so too shall their children. And you come to me with talk of this Jacob Fry. This insignificant blemish who calls himself assassin? You disrespect the very city that works day and night so that we may drink this. This miracle, this tea.
I'm nearing the end of my research. Our beloved London shall not suffer such a bothersome fool for much longer.
And what of this sister I've heard of? Miss Fry.
Miss Fry shall be gutted. soon enough. Delicious.
Sorry to interrupt, Initiate. Thought you'd like to know that Sean and Rebecca got away from Otzoberg. Berg runs a unit called Sigma Team. Violet DaCosta is his tech support. They've been hunting and killing assassins for a long time. Thank God you're all right.
Oh, tish tosh. It'll take more than a Templar super soldier to end the glorious saga of Sean Danger Hastings.
I was talking to Rebecca.
Right. Anyway, Berg's presence confirms it. The Peace of Eden is in London.
The Initiate's data sync suggests it's the Shroud.
The Templars seem to want it pretty bad all of a sudden. They must know something we don't.
The only thing we know is that we can't go up against Sigma Team alone.
Leave that to me. In the meantime, keep a low profile. Let the Initiate continue to sync the data.
Owning the railway wasn't enough. Now Starek has bought an omnibus company as well. I suppose he wants to control the neighborhood's workers and keep them under his thumb.
Pearl Attaway is Starek's competitor, is she? Perhaps it's time I went into business.
And Miss Fry, what are your plans?
I studied the history we recovered from the Kenway Mansion's hidden room. I'm off to a certain monument.
Miss Attaway.
Yes, may I? Oh. Splendid, you're here to murder me.
I what?
No matter, everyone has a price. Is this enough?
I'm not here to kill you.
Then what's your game?
Mr. Starek and the Milner Company have blocked your ambitions long enough. I have a business proposition for you.
Wonderful. Come with me. We have much to discuss, Mr.
Jacob Fry. At your service.
Truer words were never spoken.
If you'd be so kind as to take...
You must understand, I've received threats against my life. Malcolm Milner has all but waged war ever since Mr. Starek brought out his company. And no offense, I hope, but you do look the killer type.
I doubt I shall ever recover from such a slight.
What then is your interest in my redemption, Mr. Fry?
I sense an opportunity that will benefit us both.
Do you?
Is that so hard to believe?
Whatever your intentions, it will be quite the tonic to strike back against the Syndicate. I have worked for a trip to make that way transport what it is today. I will not allow. That's one of Milner's.
Come on.
Who's a good horse? You are. Doing fine. Whoa, easy!
You'll be very sorry for that.
Malcolm Milner. Starek's puppet himself.
Careful, you twats! This park scene needs to make it to the Hathaway Depot.
He thinks he can burn my buses. Let's give him a taste of his own medicine.
Let's give him the whole damn bottle. We'll turn Milner's park scene against him. But I'll need help from my gang.
Such entrepreneurial instinct, Mr. Fry. I shall leave you to it.
To my side.
This one took a shot off once. Oh, you're fighting! Sounds a bloody well right. One less.
Humanity.
No! How terrible!
Heave-ho, Jacob. Primed and ready. Thank you.
that for a taste?
I can see Milner's stock price plummeting already. You're hired. Oh, I have more business planned for us both. Drop a note to my secretary to make an appointment, and I shall reveal the next step in our scheme.
I don't actually work. Like that. The aura of death surrounds thee both.
Get thee behind me! Alas, these days, stupidity is all too prevalent. You know, I never asked your names when we last met.
I'm Evie Fry, and this is my brother Jacob.
Tell me, do you believe in ghosts?
Not particularly.
Yes.
I'm skeptical myself. Here we are, in the world's most advanced city, yet its citizens are so enthralled to the supernatural, they leave themselves vulnerable to charlatans. Which is why I joined the Ghost Club. the first society in the world to look systematically at the phenomenon. Because truth, like a spirit, must be cajoled before it will reveal itself. Will you join us?
Sounds absolutely ridiculous. Why not?
It does sound intriguing.
Splendid. I have your first case. There's been some disturbing reports about a series of assaults in Lambeth. People claim they're being attacked by an age-old demon.
Come along. We have work to do.
Yes, Gov.
You've done it now, boy!
You have no business in this area.
Very well, best of me. No point drawing this out any further.
We don't welcome your type here.
You fought well. I salute your superior skill. It was horrible. Glowing eyes, huge claws, and his laugh. Luckily, he was frightened away by some passers-by. Somebody has to do something before he attacks another.
I have you now.
Remove those weapons? Did you come here looking for trouble?
Claw marks on the walls.
You. You're with me.
If you really want me.
I have you now. Out of the way warehouse. Lots of guards. Mass lunatic inside. This is the bloody life.
Some havoc.
You won't be drowning your troubles no more.
Everything you've ever wanted, right here! Come, look in my wares! Something...
Let them know what we can...
Count on me.
Right, I'm coming to deal with
you.
I'm
gonna help you now.
That is a doornail in good riddance.
Take him out. Look alive! We've got work to do.
You'll feel my fist if you go! You gormless! He's there! I've got a shot at him!
You are asked. I swear.
not scared to die. I'm not. I'm... Oh, please help me. Oh, God. Please save me. Huh? Even been in love. I'm not scared to die. I'm not. I'm. Oh God, please save me. I swear to you, I'll come back and I'll haunt you till the end of time.
We got a visitor!
From Jack, who knows how to treat the lower classes.
Who's a good horse?
You are.
Steady on. That's the way.
Miss Fry, what a pleasant surprise.
Hello, Clara. I was just going to check on Lambeth since the asylum's closing. What brings you here?
The children in my care have been falling ill. My usual tonics aren't working. I came to...
Are you certain you're feeling all right?
Of course I am, miss.
Clara! Is there a doctor nearby?
Bring her inside. She simply collapsed?
Yes, she said the others took tonic, but it didn't work.
I should think not. Ever since Elliotson was murdered, the district has been overrun with counterfeit tonics. This one needs proper care. But without the appropriate medication, she and the others will quickly decline.
What do you need?
I need supplies. Plenty of them. And medicine. Some of the less common ingredients are being stolen and sold at auction.
I'd be happy to help.
Here's the list. Miss...
Fry. Evie Fry.
I'm Miss Nightingale. How do you do? Please hurry. We don't have much time.
Is money more important than your child's health?
Come here!
We should let the coppers settle this.
Halt! Police!
I'll get you!
Hey, what is that?
I am sorry about the price, sir.
I can ask any of my customers. This is guaranteed to cure your son's ailment.
It's just that it's so expensive.
Ah, yes. Well, ingredients are rare at present. And really, is money more important?
I don't like the looks of
her. She seems occupied.
I hope she's not in any real trouble.
This opportunity comes once in a life.
You'll regret it if I come over there.
Well, ingredients are rare at present. And it really is.
You do not want to bother me today. Don't walk away from me.
Please. I'll give you all the money I have.
Shut it. Let's go.
Let me see what I can do.
What is she doing back there?
Soon as I get over there, you're dead fucking meat!
Let me see what I can do.
She's not in any real trouble.
I can show you everything you need. I can see you think it's a bit expensive, but that's because it's the very best. Hurry, hurry. My spot is already running low. You won't
die. She escaped from my house.
Who is she hiding from, I wonder?
And by the way,
best keep an eye on her.
sorry. Whatever I did to deserve this, I'm so very sorry. But don't hurt me. Don't hurt me!
Now.
Thank you.
Please! Someone help! Please! Someone help!
Is that everything?
I can't thank you enough. These supplies are meant for Miss Nightingale.
I'm here to collect them.
They're already loaded on the cart. Please take them.
Giddy up!
You mean that cart?
Yes.
Of course it is.
Please be careful. Some of those items are fragile.
Not a moment too soon. I hope you brought the medication I requested. How is she? She will recover.
Babylon Ellie, the children.
Thanks to you, we can distribute authentic medicine now.
But is that a permanent solution?
I will petition to have regulations put in place.
Lambeth is in your debt.
It takes a long time to change things. But I'm not going anywhere, Miss Fry. Go on. That's it. Whoa! Mr. Fry, I told you to make an appointment.
My schedule was open.
You're fortunate I like you.
Internal combustion engines.
Eight small syllables that mean a great deal of money. The engines will be delivered to Milner by train. Secure them for me, and he will be devastated.
I'll need a second train to pull this off. And I think I know just the man.
So we have a deal, Mr. Fry?
You're fortunate I like you, Miss Attaway.
Moving.
I'm gonna make you pay for that.
Doing fine, Bill.
I wonder what that's all about.
Let's go.
No good will come of that.
Thank you.
So, what do you want, Fry?
What makes you so sure I want something? Perhaps I saved you out of the kindness of my own heart. Come on, let me tell you about the job.
Miller's pulling a lot of cargo there.
Just be sure to make the transfer.
Give him hell.
We don't have all day. Get cracking.
Thank you. Come on, Fry.
This one.
Come
what I'm after.
The internal combustion engine. The end of horse-drawn transport. It's like gazing into the future.
And what is the going rate for the future, do you think?
We're not selling them.
You're giving them to your contact?
You'd be paid all the same.
Who is this Pearl, anyway? How long have you been working with her?
She's a business partner. That's all you need to know.
James, I hope I didn't make it to you, la-dee-da. Slap some gold leaf here and there. I gave the wood a splash of shellac. Upholstered the lot. And how do you like the lampshades? Can you guess what Nigel's done? At Whitechapel Station. Nigel wants to make up for things, so he got you a gift.
Mr. Fry, come have a look at this. Ain't she a beauty?
Oh, well done, Nigel.
Yeah, I nicked it off the gang across town, got them all stewed, and then took it when they was asleep. Here, sir, let me show you. It's jumped. Oh, shit. Move!
Go! You look quite good with the cane.
Who's a good horse? You are. That's the way. Let's go. Walk on, girl.
Look at this mess. Young bum boozer comes in here, argues with the regulars, rattles their cage.
The lights are out.
I don't need problems.
Whatever shall
like
I do?
That.
Someone come quick!
Good Lord! Somebody help!
Whoever did this.
That one we must bear.
What did
we
just
toast?
Did you see where Bob went, mate?
What?
Death.
Bob? Bob
wants me chummies. The fellas he was arguing with left right after he did.
What made you think that was a good idea?
Don't you
think
that's nice?
Got to warn you.
So have I.
A good crowd tonight. Quite.
What's going on there?
What's the point of having this decent
luck?
Too far.
Without
our privileges, we might have
come now. I haven't forgotten the Christmas party last year.
I'm looking for Bob the Apprentice.
Yeah, I seen him. Looked like he was about to vomit. I told him to get out of it. He went to throw up in the alley.
Lucky I'm trying to keep out of trouble. Next day, my mother will be the last. Still, it'll be worth it to upend that low life.
Can't handle your drink.
We need some real authority. Woman power. Woman power too.
Steady on.
Oh! Don't try to get away from me! It won't work!
Doing fine, girl.
Easy does it.
That a girl? Blood. This doesn't look sunny for Bob.
Think I'm a children, do ya?
Blood. This doesn't look sunny for Bob.
He's crossed the wrong blokes, he has.
Slit his throat, Tim. Do it slow.
Come along, Bob. You're wanted back at the train.
Help! Someone help!
My leg's gone wrong.
Well, that's just lovely. Come on, then.
There's been a death! A murder!
Not a peep from you.
I know a dead body when I see one.
She was a pretty little ghostling! Mr. Fry?
Ladies. Silence, and I might let you live.
What's happening over there?
Keep a lookout for another tavern, would you, Mr. Fry? A fellow gets thirsty.
Looks like trouble is brewing.
Don't call for help.
What is going on?
Mr. Fry, stop! We passed the tavern!
What's this all about?
I'll send you a drink, sir! Stop!
I could certainly... It would be wise to keep quiet.
What's going on?
Oh, more trouble from the rabble, I expect.
Make a sound and it'll be your last.
Could you take a spin around the tower? I haven't been there in ages!
We're fast friends now, aren't we?
Come on, you silly mare.
Are we there yet?
I don't require a reason to end your life.
Walk on, stupid nag.
I'd rather not hurt you. Don't think I won't.
What the hell is that?
I recommend you stop struggling.
I work for the assassins.
Shh,
it's a secret. Right, isn't it, Mr. Fry?
Such wild fantasies you have, Bob.
Looks like father to me.
Husband?
Oh, bugger. What's going on now?
Shh. Not one word.
There, girl.
Could you take a spin around the tower? I haven't been there in ages!
Silence, and I might let you live.
Dave! What on earth is going on over there?
Let's take a little jaunt to the hospital, shall we? Who's a good horse?
Too fast! My stomach's in a whirl! Where's Cab Rider of Unite? Whoa!
Walk on, girl.
Too fast, yeah?
Been stuck like a pig. Here, I'll stitch you up.
I'll be needing something to numb the pain.
I'll get my whiskey.
Could you make it, Jin?
Slow down now! Doing fine, girl. Let's go.
Yeah!
Down.
I love it.
steady on.
I would like to thank our esteemed guests.
So the hints you found in the Kenway House lead to the monument.
What a wonderful use of your time, following me around asking obvious questions.
Well, since Henry isn't here, I thought you might enjoy the company.
I don't require any company, and Mr. Green is following up on some leads of his own.
Oh yes, Mr. Green, that's a fascinating idea. Oh please, Mr. Green, come and take a look at this book and stand oh so close to me, Mr. Green.
I do not. Well, perhaps you have nothing better to do, but I'm busy protecting the assassins.
Are you really? What was it Father used to say?
Don't allow personal feelings to compromise the mission.
Precisely. Anyway, I'm off. If I find any more wild geese for you to chase, I'll be in touch.
Be ever more pleasant for your absence.
In an effort to ensure so great a tragedy will never happen again.
university.
Any attention to ourselves.
To the great fire, in an effort to ensure so great a tragedy will never happen again. I would like to thank our esteemed guests, the Right Honourable Premier Disraeli, members of Parliament and others, for being here today. Our proposed legislation will ensure that houses
by side. Are little better than hovels, in crowded conditions near open flame and with few methods of fire control. Bullets can still reach you there!
It is unsafe!
No way to do something on
This looks familiar. Thank you.
It's in the very top. The key to the vault, and the shroud.
Good day, Miss Fry. I'll take that.
You want the shroud to cement your own power. But what if you cannot control it?
And why do you want the shroud? Merely to keep the Templars from having it? How like an assassin. To hold the power of eternal life, and yet be too afraid to use it.
Eternal life? Is that what you think the Shroud offers?
What I think is no longer your concern.
Follow me. Right.
Girl.
Jacob, darling, do join me.
To our fruitful partnership.
And to the shiny new engines now in my possession. Back to business. Milner's fled to the Thames, occupied with securing his ferry. It's all he has left.
Protected it with his life, no doubt.
The very thing I want you to take. Just kill him.
That's not your first glass of champagne, is it?
Success is more intoxicating than alcohol, Mr. Fry.
Then save a glass for me.
Now, what would it take to draw out Starek's pawn? The sight of his ferries in flames, perhaps?
To sink Milner's enterprise.
I'll skin you like a rabbit! There he is! Ready to fire!
What the bloody hell?
I lost the engines. So this is my comeuppance.
Pearl Attaway led me to you, not Starrick.
Then they were gonna give her again. I should never have come between Mr. Starrick and Miss Attaway. Family always stay together.
What do you mean, their family?
Pearl and I to have a real conversation.
I'll kill you!
Oh,
There you are. What are you up to now, Pearl?
My delight when he told me his true purpose. An assassin helping the Templar cause. Isn't that delicious?
It's sickening.
It's business, cousin. You glower too much, cousin. You will get your engines back. Our new motorized buses will bring us both a lot of money.
I'll need to arrange proper transport for the engines to get back to my factory. I want you at Waterloo. Personally, to ensure that nothing goes wrong.
Of course. May the Father of Understanding guide us.
Today and in all of our future endeavors, cousin. Waterloo Station.
Door's jammed. Again? Just give her a shove.
Stop that trespasser!
He's still here!
Give me the news.
Have you been reading the Moonstone? It's a treat.
Who's a good horse? You are. That's the way. That's a girl.
Yeah!
Oh, Jacob, Evie, it's you. Thank goodness.
Experimenting, are we, Alec?
Correct.
And looking a bit frazzled.
Nerves. It's those great oafs Static keeps sending round to coax me. He is offering a ridiculous amount of money.
Alec, you're not thinking of jumping ship, are you?
Never. I've been working in something in case they get too insistent. It's meant to stun an assailant, should the need arise.
Are you certain that it works?
Not as such. I've made three of them with varying degrees of acidity and whatnot. Oh, one must be the right formula.
Let's find some Staric lackeys to target then, shall we?
Speaking of Staric, he is still transmitting false information.
We could simply destroy his transmitters.
His company's too well guarded. And the bombs will help, but it would be awkward to produce bombs that potentially do not stun. Oh, wait a minute. Looks like opportunity has come knocking. Oh dear, they never looked so angry before.
Stand clear, Alec.
Let us instead play a little linguistic game with them. Take the bombs and climb onto the roof. When I say the name of a fruit, toss one near the thugs.
Right then.
I nearly forgot. Slip these into your boots, and you will henceforth be immune to all voltaic discharge. I think.
We've come to smash your place up, ain't we, Bess?
You got one of them telly what's it in here, ain't ya? You've been reading messages from the Staric Company.
That is as untrue as the notion that the Staric Telegraph Company is emitting impartial information.
So?
Come again?
Your employer's promises are nothing but hot air, and his operations are about to turn pear-shaped.
Smart Alec's got a sense of humor, has he?
What you going on about air and pears for?
Oh, I don't know, I feel rough.
Oh, that's disgusting. Go blow me!
Oh, kids, huh? Those playful young scamps get everywhere.
Listen up, Bell, or I'll thump you till your ears are ringing.
Ooh, a pun. Your wordplay delights me. And to think I worried you had the mental agility of a dollop of donkey's apples.
I'll have no more of your cheek, boy.
Say that again and I'll give you a face like a slopped arse. You're gonna feel my fist at the back of your throat.
Apples?
I think he's trying to be funny.
Oh, dropped another one, Bill. You little sod.
What? Ain't me, babe. Oh, go blimey, it's got me now.
Those rascals throwing stink bombs again. It happens all the time, isn't it?
how far you get.
One? Do you really think I would keep it here? Do you see a cable? A telegraph without a cable is about as useful as a bell without a clapper.
I'll give you a bleeding clapper.
Well, bless my boots, you're as purple as a plum.
Plum?
I feel all wobbly, Baz.
You are in shock, my dear fellow.
What'd you say?
Bravo, Alec.
Thanks to you, Jacob. Your mere presence gave me courage and resolve I never knew I had. I found myself rather witty, too.
Well, make some more bombs and let's sort out Starek's propaganda machine, shall we?
The longer we can keep Starek from spewing out false information, the more we can awaken the people with the truth about his operations.
Let's get to it, then.
Would you believe my mother says there are still some wives in her street that swear by that soothing syrup? So I took it upon myself to tell her neighbors the truth about the obnoxious draft.
Good on you, Alec. But you can't go knocking on everyone's door.
No, I wasn't always welcome. It shows how false information can be as difficult to stamp out as fishwife's profanities at Billingsgate.
Or rats in the sewers.
But if we can eradicate the source that continually feeds such detrimental trash, then little by little the truth will take the upper hand and the sham will be flushed out.
Let's crack on. Here we are.
We will have to get in without being detected, mind.
While I stun them, you sneak inside.
I shall destroy not one, but three parts of the transmitter. He'll be as good as dancing before a public toilet without a penny.
Walk on, girl. Whoa, easy!
Over here.
Dead as a drowned rat.
I say, this is becoming rather perilous, to say the least. Oh, golly gosh, I felt that. Jolly close save, that. A tad fiddly, that one, but I've pulled it as well as a dentist pulls a rotten tooth.
Move on to the next part, Alec.
I see. This is becoming rather perilous, to say the least. My dears, Jacob, Evie, thanks are once again in order for supporting what is most dear to me and to our cause, freedom of speech.
It's a blessing that you employ your genius for the common good, Alec.
However, I suggest you vacate your workshop.
No need. Not now. You've given me sacks full of courage, and besides, what with my little devices, I have all the protection I need. Should you find yourselves with a moment to spare, do drop by.
Doing fine, girl.
Sir, the engine's just pulled into Waterloo. Once Starrick's men arrive, they're gonna unload the train.
Well, not if the train has already left. Assemble a team at Charing Cross. I'll send the engines there for you to recover.
What's going on?
Ladies and gentlemen, I apologize for the delay. We will get you into the central station very soon.
Where the hell is that schedule?
Central station's closed. Attaway's orders.
You saw these blueprints, did you not? Were you aware of this floor?
It's only a minor weakness, sir. The final wagon's otherwise fortified.
What the devil's going on? The station chief is usually punctual.
What a shame. Good partnerships are hard to come by.
Ours is most certainly dissolved.
It's business, Mr. Fry. One does what one must to come out on top. Crawford will not take the news of my death lightly. He can be unpleasant when he's cross. I have sacrificed so much. I don't want to lose my buses.
When coldness or deceit shall slight the beauty now they prize, and deem it but a faded light which beams within your eyes, when hollow hearts must wear a mask.
Mr. Starrick!
I told you not to disturb me!
To break your own to see
in such a moment, I but ask that you remember me, that you remember me.
Crawford.
The luster stripped by the hands of that savage. He must be brought to justice.
Pearl would not want justice. Pearl would want vengeance.
Your passion is most welcome, Miss Thorne. But we cannot let our emotions disrupt the lawful structures of society. If we do that, the enemy wins.
It shall happen in the shadows. Miss Fry will hang from the gallows, and I will flay her brother as he comes to save her.
I suppose it must be done. Take no chances. Increase the Templar presence in London. We alone protect this city of light.
Yes, Crawford. And then we shall enter the vault and cast aside the shadows together.